I don't think I've ever seen a town quite like Shawnee. It rides the impossible line between a ghost town and a thriving little community. It's a place frozen in a permanent state of limbo. I went there expecting a declining community, but I left with one of the most incredible backstories of all time. Shawnee is located in the southern hills of Perry County, a short 2-mile drive from New Straitsville up Route 93. Shawnee was formed in 1872, 2 years after New Straitsville. The New Straitsville Mining Company exploded within the next 8 years, and by 1880 there were over 8,000 combined residents in the two towns. Things were looking up, but in 1884 tensions arose between the mining company and the workers over low-paying wages. The miners decided to strike peacefully at first, but their patience soon wore thin. After a few months, on November 13, 1884, some of the union members doused coal cars in oil and set them ablaze within the mine. This started the Great Mine Fire of New Straitsville. After several days, the fire was discovered, and it was too deep to control. The mine closed, and the miners were forced to find work elsewhere. Several years later, residents were able to use the water to make instant coffee because it was coming out of the wells at over 120 degrees. In the 1930s, local farm owners contacted Ripley's Believe It or Not, and they aired a radio broadcast claiming it was the world's greatest mine fire. This launched a massive increase in tourism. People from all over came to New Straitsville and paid a quarter to see someone fry an egg by holding it over the flaming mine shaft. Joe Blosser, longtime resident of New Straitsville, explained how when he was a kid in the 1940s, he used to throw sticks into a glowing red subsidence caused directly by the fire. According to the Lancaster Gazette, in 1938, the Works Progress Administration hired hundreds of out-of-work Ohio miners to try to stop the fire. Boreholes were drilled 100 feet deep and clay was pumped in. Old shafts were bricked up to cut off air, and trenches were dug around the non-burning parts of the coal seam. In the 1970s, Route 216 began to sink, and the state soon rerouted it, closing the old road, and nature has since reclaimed it. In spring of 2003, rangers in the Wayne National Forest began noticing giant areas of forest floor subsidence, with thick smoke pouring out. The fire had made its way into the reserve. Some say that the fire has burned more than 200 square miles of coal, but the Middle Kittanning coal seam is practically endless amounts of coal to burn. According to my research, I can only find three other coal fires that have been burning longer than New Straitsville. 134 years is an incredibly long time. I've thought about what would have happened if most of the coal seam was located directly under the town. It would be another Centralia all over again, but this time it would affect many more people. Being situated only 2 miles from New Straitsville, Shawnee has endured a similar fate. It now has about 600 residents, most of them driving 30 minutes to work in Logan. One resident, Pat Worrell, owns a carryout business in town and is very popular with the locals. He also has been robbed 40 times, so there's a trade-off. Main Street is a ghost town with overarching balconies scarily leaning forward, ready to fall at any day now. But there's an incredible beauty to this place, and the community is very tight-knit. I wouldn't be surprised if one day this place gets rebuilt from the ground up. It's a historic landmark, and the history was the spark that lit the fire under the locals long ago, quite literally. Thank you.
Unit 5 in pursuit. We got 7 very well-dressed, handsome men going southbound right now on State Route 93.
Oh, watch your girl.
Oh, man.
Watch
oh, no.
Watch your girl. That guy in the flannel's coming.